An Omaha grandmother says she's tired of having to keep the kids inside.
She says a vacant home next door is infested and dangerous.
KETV News Watch 7's Adrian Whitsett live now with a story you're seeing new at 10.
Yeah, Brandy, that home is condemned. The glass is broken out, and the woman says she sees rodents and raccoons everywhere. And tonight we found out it's by no means unique. There's hundreds of houses across the city just waiting to be torn down.
This is something Juanita Mitchell sees every day.
It's just been a mess.
The house next door is not only an eyesore.
You could see possums coming out the sewer. You could see possums just coming out the house, all up under the porch here. You know, it doesn't make sense. Every time I come out, I have to run and look.
Mitchell says the problem started 3 years ago. The women renting moved out, and other people started removing what was left.
I guess the cabinets out of there and then took the stove and stuff out.
Mitchell says she's called the city for years. They've taken pictures, even set the house for demolition, but nothing's happened.
And when my grandkids over here, we have to sit out here with the kids. You know, we can't put them in the backyard because the possums and the coons be all out there. So they have to stay in the house.
Ron Gerard, communications director for Mayor Suttle, says there are 407 houses slated for demolition in Omaha right now.
Fire damaged or structurally damaged homes are going to be given the highest priority for demolition.
And Gerard says part of the problem is getting property owners to fix the problems or tear down the home.
So you're looking at months, if not years, to get that through the court. And then you have to give them a certain period of time, even after the court case is settled, to do what they've been told to do.
Mitchell thinks she's been patient enough.
But I don't want to do all my improvement, and my value isn't going up with this junk next door to it.
Ron Gerard says there's also 4,000 buildings with violations, and he says he doesn't know how many condemned homes will be torn down this year, but the mayor has added extra funds for that program, going from $260,000 to $400,000 this year. Reporting live, Adrian Whitsett, KETV News Watch 7.